we might be intelligent.
Two minutes.
Good morning. Welcome to our Veterans Day presentation for 2021. Good morning again, and again, welcome to our Veterans Day recognition of 2021. It is my fervent hope that this time next year we will all be gathered together in the gymnasium where we will be watching this live. Veterans Day is the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month. In 1918, it was the time, day, month, and year that the armistice was signed that ended the fighting of World War I. It was supposed to be the war that ended all wars. Unfortunately, this would not be the war to end all wars, as wars and conflicts have remained across the globe. There would be another world war. There have been numerous wars in which Americans have had to shed blood in besides this. There are two commemorative days set aside to honor veterans. Memorial Day, which honors the fallen heroes of past conflicts who made the ultimate sacrifice. And there's Veterans Day today. While Memorial Day has a much more somber tone, Veterans Day has been set aside to honor all living veterans. The military men and women who serve and protect the United States come from all walks of life. Their parents, children, grandparents, friends and neighbors, teachers and co-workers. They're an important part of our communities. All veterans have not fought in wars, but all veterans have made sacrifices for this great country. If you know a veteran, please thank him or her for their service, and please, let's not forget those men and women who are currently serving in the armed forces. Some of them truly need to know that they're still being supported, especially with the recent ending of the war in Afghanistan, which ended so badly. It makes many who served during that conflict question their sacrifice. So reach out to them, thank them, but don't just thank them, remind them. Remind them that they fought the good fight, that they fought for freedom and to protect liberty and democracy against those who want to end our way of life. Honor their service for those who have fought for our freedom by taking part in protecting it yourself. The defense of freedom is not just for those in the military. Each of us shares that duty and that responsibility. You don't have to join the Army or the Navy to actively defend our way of life. Protect our freedom simply by helping to maintain it here in America. If we want to preserve our freedoms, we must put them into action. For example, by voting in elections or speaking out against any injustice. We must also ensure that everyone feels the benefits of freedom. We can do that by volunteering in our communities or showing what it really means to be an American simply by the way you behave with American pride. Right now, there's a lot of division in this great country of ours. Most of it caused by political ideology that only serves special interests or furthers various causes that are in direct opposition to the true American dream. All Americans need to remember and focus on the fact that we are all much more alike than we are different. Veterans Day isn't just a day for veterans, it's a day for all Americans. It's a day to remember what was being defended and why it is worth fighting for, historically and for the future of our great country, now and forevermore. Thank you very much.